and let's move ahead with beautiful vibes and positive energy. I want to invite Dr. Katyayani Chasti. She is the professor of Sri Padmavati Mahila Vishwavidyalaya. She's joining us from all the way from Tripura, Andhra Pradesh. Now she's going to shed light on the topic of future of capability building. Now she's present with us, and it's an immense pleasure to have you with us today, ma'am. Please start your session.
Yeah, very good afternoon to everyone. And then just now, in the last, I have been added for this session. And it's a beautiful discussion that is going on. Everybody are feeling that the youth has to have a mindset and attitude to become an employer. So yes, that is true. And now the National Education Policy 2020 is focusing on that. And then in Andhra Pradesh, our AP State Council for Higher Education is taking care in introducing this entrepreneurship in schools education from schools, and it was started, and then it will be go for even for degree and then PG. Now the structure for schooling and then even for the degree also, they are making 3+1+1 like that. And then every final year student at the degree level or a PG level, they are going to have a project with the research. So they are making them as an innovators, or they may choose a career as a self-employers. So they want to promote the talents that our youth are having. So that we are in the rigorous exercise. So from this academic year, we are going to start in all aspects, in all courses in Andhra Pradesh. I'm from the temple town of Tirupati and belongs to a professor of business management, and having an experience of 20 years plus in teaching and then making practically the building entrepreneurs in my institute. We have been, converted our students. About 1% of our students are now become an entrepreneur, and our university is a women's university especially. How difficult to make women to start a business, everybody knows, because they are going to have a multiple roles to play in their lifestyle. Even then, our girl students and women are flourishing as an entrepreneurs and as an intrapreneurs, so in some of the multinational companies. So I'm here using two words, entrepreneur and intrapreneur. If you want to become an entrepreneur, you have to start your business. If you want to become an intrapreneur, you can join as a multinational company and have a shares in it and then become an intrapreneur. So like that, how to get that attitude? What skill that our student should have it to think about what is entrepreneurship and then what is intrapreneurship? So let me share a small PPT with you. So I think everybody are able to see my PPT.
Yes, ma'am, you're yes. Presenting.
Yeah. So the topic that I have been given to discuss is future skill. What is the future skill of our student or our youth surrounding us? So it is nothing but we have to make them to make use of their talent, creativity. So how to make them to make use of that talent and creativity? There is a beautiful technique that was right now we are using in this scenario is innovation by design. So if you are going to think of a designing of a solution for a problem that everybody are facing, then that will become or lead to innovation, or sometimes it may lead to invention also. Here we are having again two terms, innovation and invention. If it is a new thing that you are going to find and you are going to create it or initiate it, that is an invention. And then innovation might be inventions are lead to the innovations, and innovation might be a improvement in the existing inventions. So a lot of improvements, that technology improvements we are seeing in the cell phones, and a lot of technology improvements that we are seeing in the TV technologies, a lot of improvement that we are seeing in the communications, networking, internet facilities. Now we are talking about the cloud storage. So all these terms, now everybody are on online because of this unexpected pandemic situation. We are learning, we are on new technologies, we are using it, we are struggling. So everything, so all these are nothing but some are inventions and some are innovations. So how one can become an innovator or an inventor? So entrepreneurship, basically it is going to start with an idea. If you are having a good idea, then that can be converted into a business, and that will make you an entrepreneur. So there is a linkage between this process of design thinking, creativity, and innovation. So here we can see that design thinking is a powerful creative problem solving technique for creating creative products and services. You can see here the figure. Can I make it? Yeah, you can see here in the figure, you are going to see the innovation at the center. You are going to have different types of innovations. So process innovations, product innovations, and we are going to have other innovations also. Here we are going to
see. 350 ಗೆ ಇತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಓಡ ಬಂದೆ ಮೂರು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಕೆಲಸದ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆ
ಸರ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಆರ್ ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ಸ್ So when you are seeing about what are the types of innovations that you are going to have it, if you're going to do something new in the products, product innovation, something new in the process, processes. When you are going to get something new in experience, for example, in this pandemic, we can't go out. So we can't go and visit doctors. We are getting online doctors. We can't go and purchase our provisions and vegetables. Then we are getting an online fruit baskets, and then we are going to vegetable baskets like that. So on everything is online right now. Okay, even you are not going to the schools and then colleges. You are teaching it. You are continuing and finishing your syllabuses. Even we are conducting some online tests, objective type and like that. We are assessing the how far they are able to learn. So learning capabilities are increasing and teaching capabilities are increasing. And then we are able to make it a mentorship to the students successfully. And then we are seeing different behavioral patterns also. We are seeing it. Student will be online, but he won't be an alert person. So how to make them alert? So using of a breakout rooms or making them interact with problems that we are teaching. Like that, we are making them alert as we are doing in a physical facility. So like that, but only the thing is we are going to have a communication technology problems, network problems. So sometimes if the power goes, everything will be disconnected. So that will be there, that we can't avoid it. But anyway, but we are able to manage. We are able to finish our syllabus. So like that, students, don't stop learning. Learning is a continuous process. Even at our age, we prefer to learn from you students. If you are going to raise the questions, which are making us to think in that angle, and then we are going to learn something. We are going to learn from students. We are going to learn from our colleagues. So we are going to learn from our teachers from time to time. And we are going to learn from the new technologies that are coming into the market. So learning should not be stopped. We have to continue. So then that will make you to become a critical thinker, and that will make you to become an innovator. So as we can see that design thinking is a mindset. It is not a tool, or it is not a having a series of steps. It is just simply mindset. So we are having a different automated solutions we are coming across and we are using right now. If you want to pay or if you want to buy anything, we are using Amazon Pay, Phone Pay, everything we are doing in online. We are not using previously. We used to issue the checks, okay, or we are going to pay the cash. But nowadays we are ordering all the type of goods. So, and then we are getting online and then we are paying online. So there is a process change, complete process change. And new products also came. What products now came? So the products for having an automation, washing of clothes, washing of vessels, and then sanitizer sprayers. Okay, so some new products because of this pandemic, lot of new products came, lot of technology improvement has came, and some people, they have changed their business from hotels. So suppose because we are not going to visit the hotels, what they are doing right now, they are becoming a like a curry points. They are making home delivery of the famous recipes that they are having to the home delivery through Swiggy and using all that online. So, and some people who are selling the provisions in retail and wholesale, they are becoming like online. So they are using digital marketing technologies, everybody. Even the students, by sitting at home, if they are having a talent dress designing, they are doing using digital market and then social media like YouTube and Twitter. Within their friend circle, they are supplying and then they are ready. So having that thought, that attitude, yes, I'm having a lot of time. I need not go to school or college. I can listen online and then I can also do online. So they have started their own businesses and they are flourishing, they are earning while learning. So like that, students, so you can earn while learning. But your mindset should be do something which is new, which might be useful to the people in the society. So when you think about a solution for a problem that the people are facing it, then automatically that will lead you to be a entrepreneur. Okay. So that's why design thinking is a communication of innovation, an art of innovation, and human-centered approach to innovation. These are the three words that you have to remember in your mind when you want to become an entrepreneur. First, you become an innovator. So it's just an art of innovation. You need not think that I'm not creative, I may not able to innovate, I don't have an ideas like that, but just think, what is the problem that you are facing in your life right now? Does that problem is having a solution? If not, why don't you think a solution for that? That mindset, that attitude will make you to become a successful innovator, and automatically it will may lead to become a startup owner. So that's why if you think of human-centered approach, So what for you were developing? So many scientists are there. Scientific professors are there. They are doing lot of research, lot of research. They will be getting funding from lot of DST, DBT, like that government funding agencies. But when they think that what for we are doing that research, is it useful for the human surrounding you? Is it going to solve a problem of human being? Then definitely that will become an innovation. So whatever money that and effort that we are putting in research should be converted into a knowledge which is to be useful to the human. Then only that will be useful knowledge. Otherwise we can't acknowledge it as a knowledge at all. So like that, if you set your mindset, yes, I want to do something which is useful. What I can do to the society? When you are having a questioning in your mind, this, then definitely you are going to become an innovator. So this mindset, this attitude that everyone has to have it. From the school children to the graduations or post-graduations or research scholars or the faculty in the higher education can have that. So we are seeing types of innovations. When we are seeing innovation, when you want to start a business with using that innovation, you have to think of these three qualifiers. One is people desirability. Another one is business viability. And another one is technology feasibility. If people are not interested in buying your product or a process that you have created, so there is no use of creation of that. So that's why you have to think of people desirability. Once you get people desirable product, whether it is technically possible to build that or technically feasible, economically feasible, then that is technical feasibility and business viability. When you say it is economically feasible, yes, that business can go ahead with success. When you say with technology, I can create, I can manufacture that particular product, I can make that process available to the users, then we can say that it is technology feasibility. So when you keep it, all these three, people desirability, business viability, and technology feasibility in your minds, then these are the qualifiers for your successful innovation and successful business. So that's why design thinking process is an awesome. So everybody should think in this way. When you want to do something, when you get an idea, yes, I have to be recognizable by doing something new. So then use this design thinking approach or a mindset. So here, design thinking approach or a mindset will start with empathize. Empathize is nothing but understanding your user, understanding your consumer, understanding your customer needs. When you put your legs in the shoes of a customer or a consumer or a user, then automatically you are going to think in their way. Like a railway reservation system. Previously, we don't have an online railway reservation system. We used to go to rail station and then we are going to book the tickets by writing manually the form. but the forms are available right now and online, and then we are sitting at home and then we are doing our railway reservation, and even the bus reservation is also now available online. That is a need that we want, and even now we are able to buy our all needy things by sitting at online from Amazon or from any other IndiaMart. Like that, we are having a lot of online portals. You can also become a partner for that, for selling of your product and your talent also. You can become a tutor if you are very good in analytical skills or very good in communication skills. You can become an online tutor. If you are very good in coding, yes, become an online tutor. Very good in drawing, you can become a 3D drawing and using CAD, CAM and all that. So very good in software, then become a good coder and then become a programmer and become a tutor also. His 10th class student can teach to 3rd class student. Like that, if you are able to think of it, what I can do, what actually user need. So then automatically you are going to find out what is to be done. So that is the defined state. So in the empathize, what are the problems and needs you will understand, and then you are going to define that particular problem, what to be done. Then around that environment, problem in environment, so then you are going to find out some solutions. Then that is nothing but an ideate mindset. You can brainstorm with your friends. You can sit your friend with you along with your friends and then brainstorm it. What could be the solution for that? So you will get the best solution if you are going to ideate properly, systematic way. Even you need not know the knowledge in depth, but you know that that particular technology can be useful for creating a solution for your problem. Then you can start. You can take mentorship for going in depth with the knowledge that you require. Like that, you ideate with an ideas. Then that idea to be implemented by creating a prototypes. You know that in the school days, teacher used to give the creation of a rail or like a prototype, so or a garden or a house like that. We used to have Dhanmukol sheets and then brown sheets and drawing sheets. We used to, and then we are going to paste it, and then beautifully we will make that prototype, and then we are going to show it to the teacher. I have done very good, but our parents used to help us. That is a prototype, no? Even you might have done with the paper and pencil and pen cap. You might have done with aeroplanes. You might have done with the ships. When the rain is come, you are going to leave the ships in the rainwater, and then we used to enjoy. That is also a prototype. You are having that creative mind. You are having that innovative mind. But when you grow and then get the degrees, you will forget about that. You won't consider that is required right now. But friends, you have to rethink right now what prototype that you can do it. But it should resemble the idea that you got. It should resemble all functional things that has to be included in your solution. Is met or not? Whether it might be an engineering drawing, or it might be using wooden strips and then doing the prototype. But it should be a less cost and less resources it has to do it. And then prototype has to be built within a short time. And then it has to be tested with the actual user. Like a toys, Chinese toys, you know that every Chinese toy will be resembling the actual car models. Like that, you can have your own toys. Those are nothing but prototypes. You test it with the user, and then whether user is satisfied, then you can go for actual prototype in a small scale. And then if it is satisfied for a few users, get the feedback. If the feedback is ready and useful, then we can go for actual manufacturing and then go for the startup. That will be a good business idea. But the time duration of ideation, prototype, and testing should be iterative and should be sharp. If you keep on spending more and more time on prototype and testing, then automatically that technology might come out and then somebody will be doing the similar thing. And then your design effort and your prototype effort will be become obsolete. So friends, you have to be very focused way once you got a true need and once you are able to define your problem and you are able to ideate it, do it very quickly and then go for a prototype, real prototype testing and then go for startup. So because the government of India now announced a lot of funding for the startups, especially youth, women. So a lot of fund is there with the government of India, with the MSME we are having fund, with CB we are having fund, with DST we are having fund, DBT we are having fund, with Atal Incubation Center we are having fund. Only thing is we have to be, have that mindset and focus. Yes. Then you can become an entrepreneur. So, how you are going to define your problem? Here, just simply write a question like, how might we find a solution for a problem? It can be done as a 20-minute exercise also with the group. And after doing this brainstorming session, we can have discuss with the groups what you have done it. So what is your how might we statement around the problem that we are having? So we can take it any challenge. How might we design a software for making every student alert and then learn what the teacher is telling? So like that, you are going to take up one challenge and then you can write how might we. Then we are going to think about what are the boundary variables for that. Explicit variables and implicit variables, both we are going to think about it. Then automatically you will be clear about what you want to do it. Then I have told the first step is empathy, empathize. So it will focus on human values. What is in the mind of the user, you have to get it. So empathy for people you are designing for and feedback from these users is a fundamental to good design. if you don't listen properly, you should have a good listening skills, you should have a good observation skills, you should have a good documentation skills. What feedback the user is giving. Then that will be a good design. So it is very keen to understand, very essential to understand what consumer is telling, what customer is telling. I told you, no, consumer is different from customer. Sometimes customer is also a consumer. So for example, chocolates. Parents will buy the chocolates. Sometimes parents may not eat chocolates, but they will buy the chocolates for their children. So children here are the consumers, but the customers are the parents. Like that we are going to have. So both the person's feedback is very necessary for having a good design of good flavor of chocolates, good flavor of ice creams, good flavor of desserts, like that. So we can, how to get the feedback? We are having different ways to use it to get the feedback. So we'll seek stories from them, or we'll explore their feelings, or we can focus on needs, not the solutions. We are not going to ask what solution that you want. Just we want to ask what you need. Then the responsibility is on yours to find a solution for the need that will met. And then we are going to have a story behind the story also. We can think of it. Some story that they are telling it. What is the story behind that story? If you expand your, explore yourself, then automatically you will finding out their feelings, their likes, their dislikes, what are the problems that they're facing it like that. And continuous follow-up of your users and customers is also required. What type of interaction can we have? We can conduct surveys. We can have a focus group. That means we are going to select some of the people and then we'll focus on their feelings, their dislikes and all that. That also can be done. We can conduct interviews. Or we can do contextual inquiries, observations. And you also will become an immersion as like a customer, and then you can experience and then find out the need. And you can also become a participatory research, can conduct or co-creation with your friends, with similar type of products and services who are offering with them. You can cooperate and then you can conduct some participatory research. So these are the types of interactions you have to learn to do that. So if you want to finish the empathizing, because it is an important first task that will lead to other tasks in this mindset approach of design thinking. You have to build a personal template, personal template of a user. So what it should consist? Just have a photograph if they are willing to give, or else just write their name, or if they don't want also, just describe their characteristics, age, profession, and income level, or what is their interest code, what they want to give. That also you make mention in it, and then find out what are their interests. Find out their frustrations also, and find out their likes and dislikes, and find out their goals, what they want to achieve in future, and find out their daily routine tasks, when they will wake up, what they're going to do, what their next, like that. And find out their role models and what makes them motivated in their life, what they are going to become, because goals and motivations both are linked. Then from that, you will be understanding their mindset, their feelings, their likes, their frustrations. They will give the needs of them. So then again, construct how might we question. After collecting this empathy, before collecting personal information from the user, you have written roughly how might we question. And then after collecting personal information, then you are going to construct again how might we. It will be very clear here. So how might we open up more opportunities for special needs youth and families? So like disabled persons, disabled children, how we can meet their special needs with their actual children and also with their family. How might we put more pressure on countries to respect human rights? So there is a lot of human rights problems are going on in different countries. So what policies that you are going to suggest so that human rights are protected? And how might we help sick elderly people to die with dignity? Like cancer patients, we know that they are going to die. But how will make them happy and then have a pleasant mindset while they're exercising that inevitable process? Like that, you can think of anything. Just I have given an example here, but you can think of anything. So coming to, after empathizing, coming to ideation place. So you are observing here, how many rods? How many rods? Some people might observe 3 rods. Some might be visualizing 4 rods. Some might be visualizing more than that also. So you have to think that when you are doing an ideation, so they are quarreling. Somebody is telling that 4 and someone is telling, no, it is 3. No matter how good you think, don't think that always others also think as you think. That you have to keep it in your mind. That's why we are emphasizing that, yeah, we spend good time and then good focus on empathy step so that you will be finding out the good need properly. Then automatically ideation will be in accurate way. Okay. So according to the Einstein, creativity is 1% and 99% is a perspiration. So you have to keep those words in your mind when you are ideating. It should be worth pursuing or not, you have to make out. So the best way to have a good idea is to have a lot of ideas similar to that. So like this, you are going to make out ideations, good ideations, good solutions that we can give it. And change your perseverance angle. So you can have a certain questions like this. You can ask yourself, you were 5 years old, what you're going to do? If you have a 5.1 million budget with you, then what you are going to do? So if you want to have a solution for creation of a fund, then what you are going to do? So you should have a different angle of perseverance of every question that you are going to keep it, that will come to your mind. Then automatically your ideation will be proper. So you can use brainstorming as a good technique. So which will encourage wild ideas, and then good ideas, bad ideas, and then in last you are going to have a combination of idea which is going to be a good solution for the problem that you are going to solve it. So see here, prototypes. So different prototypes are here. You can see blue and red animals, and then you have seen blue and red separately, and then you are having a combination red, blue, red, and red, blue, blue, like that, or two blues and red, like that. So you can have a build a model according to the solution that, or you can model, prototype can be a model, or it can be a skit also. You can have a film, you can create a space, or you can draw a storyboard. So this is how we can create our prototypes. See, simply a prototype is like a plane. Just they have used a chart, red chart, and then a cap, pen cap, and clip at the end. That makes a prototype of a plane. Usually with the paper, plain paper, we used to do it when we are children. Now we have used it like a nose. We have used a pen cap and also a clip at the end. Like that also we can do it. Like this we have to do it and then test it. We have to test. And this test to be passed by the user. Then only you are successful. So, and then you are going to think of it from most viable product. So here we can see the stages of development of a light in the dark night times. So first they have used a candle. It is a minimum viable. And then they have used with the oil and then cotton thread, a closed glass kettle. That is also one of the light. And now we are using electrical bulb. In this electrical bulb also, we used to have LED bulbs, solar bulbs, like the different types. So we have to have a viable product when that product is having a growth. Long-term growth. Technology might be changing like this, but manufacturing of the lights and essential use of lights are not changing. It is growing usage. We want small bulbs, we want big bulbs, we want more watts bulbs, like that. Different sizes, different technologies are coming. So we have to choose that product which is going to have a long-term growth. That will be a viable product. And minimum viable product, we have to first come out and then immediately start your startup and then keep on adding different varieties of products to the existing product line. So that will make you to end up with the proof of concept, which is going to be a start point for the entrepreneurs. So this proof of concept will be converted into business idea, and business idea will be made into, business model, and then that business model will be presented to the funding agencies, get the fund, and then start the business. So these are the steps that you are going to have. So from creative mind to design thinking mindset to thinking of having more minimum viable product and then creation of a proof of concept. So this is an approach that if you follow, then definitely you will become a innovator, and then leads to you to start your own business. I'm giving it a blank screen to say thank you, and also think of it, start with a blank mind and then have good idea. Sit idle and then do it. Find out what the needs of the customers and needs of the users, needs of the human beings around you. And then, so even in the pandemic, some businesses got losses, but they have revived very quickly by entering into the a different variety of strategies. We are having Uber and all that, because the traveling is constrained right now. So they are doing car repairs and maintenance, and also they are lending scooters for supply of consumer products to the customers. Like that, they have converted their business like that. Okay, so coming home and then doing maintenance of the cars and scooters, because everybody wants to have travel on their own car and own scooter like that, because they don't want to hire other person drive cars. So that is the pandemic situation that they drew. But they are using that cars what they are having. They are making use for having an online businesses. Okay, so like this, you can think of it a good idea, and you can become a good creator and good innovator and good businessman. So this is what I want to tell as a future skill set that you have to learn. Being an enthusiasm to do something new and something you want to settle in your career. Thank you, Mr. Manish Gaur and team, for giving me this opportunity to discuss with the young students and enthusiastic faculty who are there on this forum. Thank you, Samira. Yeah, I will end my
presentation. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, Dr. Katya Yani, ma'am. We really loved each and every moment of your presentation, and you have enlightened us. You know, all of the attendees are praising you, and we have deep down we will cherish all of the information that you have shared with us. But ma'am, also we have to keep in mind, everybody, that we are also running out of time as well. So we would not be taking apologies from my side. We would not be taking questions. Let's just move ahead directly with the panel discussion. Once again, I want to thank our third mentor and speaker, Dr. Katya Rani. She is the professor, as I said, of Sri Padmavati Mahila Vishwavidyalaya, and she joined us from Andhra Pradesh. Thank you so much, ma'am, for enlightening us today.
Yeah, thank you, Samira, for giving this opportunity. If you are having any questions, you can send to Manish Kaur, and then I will be clarifying offline.